Oregon Bay. Pelican Bay is a level 5 institution located on the Oregon border, 15 minutes from Oregon. You know, 60% of people there are from Los Angeles, but they have us way up north. I had an indeterminate shoe term. I was locked in South Texas confinement for 5 years. I spent 5 years there. I came out 1 hour a day, sometimes 90 minutes, depending on how I felt. It was there I began to work on Monster, the book. And I didn't really anticipate any response. Actually, I was actually bleeding. Feeling like, you know, this was the exorcism, you know what I'm saying? Getting off my chest, some shit I did to the black community, and felt awkward about coming to my consciousness. So I wrote it there, you know. Illuminati is an illuminated few. It means control. We have been duped into believing that we have been citizens of this country. Not only New Africans, but Americans. There is no country. America is not a country, it's an empire. And inside of it, just like Rome, there are several nations and nationalities, those willing to break free if they could. But the Illuminati has such a hold on us. As a consequence of economics, we become a consumer society. And capitalism has ripped and torn apart nations and created tears and got us eating at flea markets and swap meets. And y'all think that shit is real. Have people come up to another level than where we at already. I'm already unstable. I need some yak and a blunt. I can get off. Give me a pistol and I'm gone. For sure. As long as they got banks open, we have money. You get a real motherfucker. And they can withdraw in a minute. But that's a motherfucker. All this shit. But I had this shit last time, fool. Well, it's far gone, motherfucker. I'm a real dude. You know, I ain't trying to put no errors. I made a little money, $850,000. That ain't shit. For sure. May seem like a lot. But when it's tax-free, come out of the bank, that's a lot of money. But when you fuck with some legal shit, that ain't shit. I was saying with like this far up in my pocket, yo. Look, I'm a thug motherfucker. Ain't never had a job. Also, I write this book. Boom, book blow up. Pay a motherfucker. Riches. Real shit. How niggas ain't knowing. I'm telling you, real shit. Money. Cars. Fresh ass boots. All that old shit. Jewelry. Thug shit. Book blew up. All the motherfuckers came. People Magazine. Esquire. LA Times. New York Times. The Globe. Boston. Oh man, Washington Post. Motherfuckers was on me, the New Yorker. First word they want to know, did you really write this book? How could an uneducated motherfucker drop out of sixth grade, go to prison? We have set you up for failure, period. You do not breathe, period. You're gonna go to prison, juvenile hall, camp, youth authority, prison. You're gonna join a prison gang, you're gonna either get stabbed, you're gonna stab people, you're gonna spend less rest of your fucking life in solitary confinement. You are finished, Cody Scott. And I said, no. Fuck no. Hell no. I ain't finished, yo. Got a spirit of a thug in me. And not just no regular ordinary thug. I don't know, like Sin Q. Motherfuckers rebelling against the system. And that's thug shit. Boom. They wheeled me out, chained me up, dressed me up, sent me in front of these motherfucking cameras. And Whitey was like, feeding on a motherfucker. Because it was the first time that a real motherfucker spoke from the heart. Florence and Normandy, Monster Cody. A-Trey Gangsters on the real. Real thug motherfuckers. Motherfuckers want to be like us. All over this motherfucker. And I ain't proud of this shit. We get it. That's fucked up. Now it's time to make amends. What we're saying now is this. Period. The book blew up. It was necessary, but it wasn't sufficient. We got to drop more. We got to do more. Because that's only print. And black people, unfortunately, do not. Can't beat BB up in the 60s. Bogus Red threw him in the trash can. Homie still defended. We got to fight Friday. After school, we got to fight. You know how it is. They went inside of Hobart. Friday, homies. Head up. That's the usual, dude. Niggas are tight. 60s are dogs. We ain't tripping. Head up. Handle that beef. Squash it. Step on. Fatty started fighting with Tyrone. Tyrone's brother was Big Rick, OG 60, Ryder, Moneymaker, Hustler, Thug Motherfucker. Him and Fatty fight. Boom, bat, boom, both dick youngsters. Boom, bat, boom, bat, 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 boom. Squalling. school named Daryl Oaks, the hood just recruited. He was originally from 9-0. Went around the corner, got the strap, my homie. Came back, he was on the hood like 2 days. He thought it was something more serious than just the fisticuffs. And that's all it was. And it's 79. Ooh, it's the 70s. It's September, 79. Man, it's still the 70s. It's all about this, fool. Fool come back with the heat. Tell Fatty, move, dunk, boom, boom. Kill Tyrone, shoot him in the head and the chest. Shoot Bogart, boom, from the 60s in the stomach. That's the break. We all break too. We're like, damn! Man, what you tripping on? 60s come in the hood, though. Big Rick, the OG, Babyface, Baby Huey, Motor Mouse, 60s, OGs, killers. Come in the hood. All they want is a shooter. Kill their brother. They ain't tripping. Like, man, who wants my motherfucker to kill my brother? So Big Rick said. And we was like, man, we don't know him. We didn't. He just started claiming the hood in 2 days. We couldn't give him up. We didn't know the motherfucker. Fools took the other side of us saying we ain't giving him up. We threw a big meeting, big sidewinder, big Keystone all in from the 60s, Big Joe Rat, Mumbles, Mumpy, threw a big meeting at the park. The meeting became a big gang fight. It fell into name calling, disrespect. People started getting hit, bombed on. It turned a big gang fight. Pigs came, helicopter 40 feet off the ground, ran everybody off. From that point, September 27th, 1979, the Roman 60s and the A-Trades have been mortal enemies. They've killed over 20 of my homies, and we've killed over, I'm sure, 27, 28, 9. Of them, black men, young men, unfortunately, just been getting cut down this war since September 27th, 29th, 79, and it's hectic. I've been shot 7 times, I've been shot 6 times by Rural 60s, 6 times at once. One time I was robbing a man, was shot. The war is taking a toll. Every criminal act I've committed has been in commission in trying to destroy in some aspect of Rural 60s. Crip organization, and my whole life has been spent primarily on that mission. Today, even now, I consider myself a rolling 60 killer. But I'm like, money I got, or whatever. Dude shot me 6 times, killed 20 of my homies. Motherfuckers I knew. You know what I'm saying? I grew up with. Played Pop Warner with. My mothers knew their mothers. Broken houses with these motherfuckers. Rolled bicycles. Swing. Nigga, I know Red Lines, no Mongoose, nigga. Swins, Huffies. Nigga, I roll Huffies with these motherfuckers. Street King skates. Not no motherfucking big rubber wheels, nigga. Street Kings. Nigga, I'm 34. I was born in 63. Not 73. I've been around, man, with the school, man. Graduated in 75. Went to the 7th grade. And that was it. Motherfucker had to represent. From that point forward, I've been at war with not only motherfuckers around me, but with my own motherfucking self. Because I'm really a nice guy. And I don't like killing motherfuckers. But people around me tend to fall on sharp shit. They tend to get holes in their chest. They tend to just get eruptions of the heart and aneurysms and just eternal bleeding. Motherfuckers be around me and I don't know. Motherfuckers be falling around. Damn, I'll be like, damn, nigga, get up. And they think I shot him or something. I don't know what. Your dead homies died because of you. Because you here because they dead. Because if they was alive, you'd be dead. Represent that shit, nigga. Because you got young dudes out there courageous, ain't giving a fuck, ain't got a job, ain't got no education. Young riders, all they talk about is getting some fresh-ass gear. Some boss gear, Kanai, FUBU. Motherfuckers talking about getting some fresh ass Jordans, blue and gray. Motherfucking hat with your hood on it, representing. That's all you living for. It's for the next day to be fresh and get a page from a bitch you want to dig out. Ain't that real, nigga? You talking about you slang, get your money, get your chips. But the point is, some motherfuckers violate your neighborhood, you gotta go kill them. What happens? You kill them, they kill you, dead homies. The dude come up to me, but not from my table. Free Remy, we got Remy flowing. threw a 60 in my face. I look in his eyes, though. He's looking above me. So I say, 30 in my fucking, right on top of me. I'm like, oh. There'll be a shootout in this motherfucker. That's what I thought. And I went to the bathroom, you know, take my shit in the mirror, make sure I wasn't bulging and shit. Go back up there, was ready to die. Sat in the booth, took a shot of Remy, and just turned around, look, take my hat off, took my handkerchief, black handkerchief, rubbed my hair, make sure they see me, put my hat back on, turned my head. I went to get shot in the back of the head. Didn't get shot like about 5 minutes. I'm like, these motherfuckers, yeah. You can't even know who I am. They gutless. And I'm a shark. I had to eat these motherfuckers up. But I had these sisters with me. I had 3 sisters with me. Probably the sisters in the music industry. And I couldn't fuck up. Because it was been on me. I seen Papi L cute in the 60s. I walked up to him. I said, hey, yo. I said, I'm Monster, man. Gangster. I got Rizzi. I pulled him to me. I said, look. I ain't tripping. You ain't tripping, I ain't tripping. I said, good to see you, though. I walked away. And that motherfucker was like this. At that point, because I had it, dead bang. If I was on some 60 killing shit still, I'm not saying I won't be tomorrow, but then I ain't, and then I wasn't. But like, it's right. For sure. And if they push up on me, I got to do what I got to do. And if I see someone, it may be a good day. I may be smoking a blunt, drinking some Zay, yak, and I just may say, fucking just go kill one of the motherfuckers. That's just me. Somebody here, right? We ain't got no skills. We ain't got no vocational, technical skills. Motherfuckers is nothing. Selling drugs, trying to get up in this music industry. Motherfuckers trying to live. Motherfuckers trying to be like Master P. For that black sugar. Puppy. Regular motherfucker from the street, man. Jermaine Dupri. You know, motherfucker Steve, man, up north. AWOL Records. Just regular motherfuckers in the street, man. DJ Quick. Motherfuckers coming up. We know he's in the street. Not no motherfuckers like old bitch ass Ice Cube. Ice Cube.
Look at him, remember.
O'Shea's cool, right? I mean, O'Shea in the strength that the brother's an entertainer. Other than that, he ain't a gangster. He ain't shot nobody. He ain't from 111. He ain't from neighborhood. Grew up in, what, 108th Van Wick, something like that. Van S. Van Wick, some shit. He ain't a gangster. But the way he parlays, he tends to make people believe he's a real G. And to be a G means to be able to put work in and be in the street and be respected. When you can come on 108th and Western without WC, that's the real motherfuckers. It means being able to, you know, write motherfuckers like JD and send some chips. Get a lawyer for a motherfucker. Real G shit. Oh, he's an entertainer. I know, probably got some dope lyrics, but he ain't living that shit. And motherfuckers tend to think that he is. I be getting letters. My first thing told me, what's up with Ice Cube, your OG homie? And that ain't true. Ice Cube is not a Crip. He's not a blood. He's not really a thug. He's an entertainer. And that's the real. That's the dope. And you gotta get that bullshit out your head. Because what he's talking about, he ain't living. And what I lived is what I'm talking about. To my bullet holes, scars. To my 19, 20 years in prison. YA, camp, juvenile hall. San Quentin, Folsom, Soledad, Corcoran, Pelican Bay, Chino, the hoes. Ice Cube ain't never been nowhere. He ain't never did no time. He ain't had to face no motherfucking Mexicans. Except on the mic. And that's real. Don't be following no bullshit. Because bullshit will get you killed. Real shit will get you killed. But bullshit will get you killed for sure.
You got shooters, just like you got guards. You got motherfuckers who gonna do three throws. You got motherfuckers that snipe. You got motherfuckers who do banks. You got motherfuckers that do other shit. Dribble, cross-crisp, and all that other shit. I ain't in the sport. I wear this shit because this gang shit. I'm just saying, man. Man, just like sport. Everybody trying to recruit. We got to have a scout and odds and all that old bullshit. Like any other motherfucker, man. Group straight up. Representing. And hold up. Go back, man.
Made straight gangster, homie.
All right.
Made straight gangster. West side, homie.
Yeah, I know. I stay in y'all good, I'm Florence, you know me.
I'm Master Cody.
Oh, for real? What's up?
What's your name, homie?
Chaos.
What's up, Chaos? So that's someone sponsor you into the hood. You may have played Pop Warner with him. You may have had sex with his sister, humped her, or played hide and go get it with her. But you look up to him because he dresses cool. He got some Wallabies on. He's fresh. He's kicking it. And not no nutrient Wallabies. Talk from the 70s. He's dude dressing cool. Got some corduroys on with his little cuff, a rolling shirt. Maybe got a, you know, pressing curl and shit, an earring. And that shit is fresh. Back in the 70s, you're like, damn, man, that's it. I want to be like him. But he's a gangster. He's a hustler. He belongs to a hood. So you start joining a hood to identify with him, but then you start identifying with other people you meet who are at just as cool as him. So next thing you know, these dudes get hurt. One of them get hurt who you dig. And and you be like, damn, man, I dig this dude. You go retaliating the dudes who hurt your friend, it becomes a gang situation. Next thing you know, y'all up against the military, y'all become friends, then y'all become intertwined in this action of criminality, and then y'all become a militarized zone where this hood, this house, this particular street is being clocked by dudes who know you shot their friends, so now y'all locked in with the heat. So now I'm like, damn. See, y'all start claiming that shit, representing the scheme of things as far as South Central goes and the whole culture of banging. My neighborhood is small, like 350 people, and that's a small hood in South Central. My hood might be in this military. It's military inclined. We get our kicks off killing motherfuckers. Riding, banging, putting guns, shooting, robbing, taking shit.
It's just that we at war with the Serenios. There ain't no race war. It's the Serenios, the banging ones. If they get an order to move on one of us in our neighborhood, they move, right? And brothers and Crips and brothers and shit ain't overstanding that. They move in retaliation, right? They should move on the Mexicans first. Fuck them and the enemy. Straight up. Fuck the Mexican mafia. That's the ones that's calling the shot. It ain't no race war. We ain't got nothing against Mexicans. We ain't racist. They ain't racist. But them motherfucking Serenios, motherfucking sewer rat ass motherfuckers, them the ones that's on. It's on with them for sure. The main pursuit is after the almighty dollar. The dollar is the main source of being, health, and prosperity in this society. Because dollars come first. So the man or the woman, they become secondary in the equation in this society. So what they try to do is try to either get the money or try to out-equate the money. And as a consequence of that, they become criminals. Criminality, man, and the different classes and things that it creates, the haves and the have-nots. Some of us have not, and those who have, we try to get what they've got by any means necessary. Because we take what Malcolm said literally without analyzing what Malcolm really meant. And a lot of times, man, shit just happens, man. You know, we develop like that. The point is, we're under attack. And we try to do whatever we can, man, outside of the workforce, outside of the capitalist grind, to do what we can on the underground. And that's the black market, man. They call it the black market, we call it the underground, we call it the grind, we call it the hustle, whatever you call it, is that you get your money outside of the system, you ain't paying taxes. You are at odds, ominously, with the system. You know, say you're outlaw, and that's what we consider ourselves an outlaw. So regardless, man, we do it legally or illegally. We just don't click with the system. Cody, you made straight gangster. Get on the film, nigga. Represent the Cajun, nigga. Fuck them Mexicans, nigga. Represent that shit. A Cajun OG. Fuck them Mexicans. That be
good. Now they call me Capone.
Represent, nigga. Man. For sure. The police out here primarily arrest criminals, irregardless of their hue, criminal allegiance, sect, religion, faith, all that. They are out here to arrest criminals. And gang members tend to fall into the criminal realm. They're criminals. They shoot, kill, pack illegal weapons. They're criminals. So as a consequence of that, they have to have a gang division of the police department. No, but the pigs ain't out just to arrest a certain person. They are anti-criminal. I ain't mad at them. That's their job. Father, no, I ain't got nothing against them. As far as they being soldiers, taking money out of the bank. If they threaten me on some activity, I got to get down with them. That's the rules. Well, I ain't gonna fuck with him for no reason, and they ain't gonna fuck with me. Cause I drive by the rules. I ain't got nothing against 5-0. They push up on me, I'm getting ill. And the motherfuckers know it.
I'm sitting on my porch cooling, smoking a blunt. We use legal medicinal purposes. And the pigs roll by. I ain't talking about 5-0. Police, pigs, one time, I'm breaking. It's brothers and sisters in that motherfucker. And I know they're there to protect me and my property. See, that's the whole thing with us in America. Property relations. They got property and we don't. We rent. We don't own. As a consequence of them owning and us renting, they are landlords. And because they are lords, they can call the police. Because they pay taxes. And they're coming to defend the lords. The vengeance angels, the pigs, the police. 5-0, one time. Rollers! The enemy. Soldiers. For sure.
About it, nigga got smoked by a fiend. Tryna floss on him, blind to a broken man's dream. A hard lesson, court cases keep him guessing. Plea bargain ain't an option now, so I'm stressing. Cost me more to be free than a life in the pen. Making money off of cuss words, writing again. Learn how to think ahead, so I fight with my pen. Late night, down sunset, liking the sin. What's the worst they can do to a nigga? Got me lost in hell to live and die in LA on bail. My angels sing.
And I know a lot of brothers and sisters are feeling that now as the consequence of Pop articulating it, that a lot of us are just unhappy in this existence as a consequence of things that we've seen, people we've known, deaths we've come across. And none of us are really happy here. You know what I'm saying? So life as an existence is just here, then it's there, then I'm rolling. And that's how it is, you know, for real, you know.
Bent, gotta represent, Southside, Drope, L.A., every day, nigga, month, yeah. 34 to be exact, niggas fear me. Atomic dog, I'm in your zone, your area. Bull massive, pit bull terrier. I'm coming through like the wooed up in chambers. Third light, get it right, nigga, danger. Sending shots to my body, ain't no killing me. Lock and load, double back, I had you feeling me. 40 Glock up on your block, headshot. Chest plate getting blown when the nine knocks. And in the distance, ain't no resistance. Say your homeboy swear they gonna murder me. Said they heard of me, think I'm on a murder spree. But when they roll up, Chase try to find me. That's when I'm dumping with the fat Mac 90. From the cradle to the grave, I've been kicking static. I've been around from revolvers to automatic. See, I'm a stand-up, stomp-down soldier. Much older, not from back then. When I was thugging in my stones on my black swim. See, I'm a G, nigga, married to the thug shit. Here the COE, Sherm sticks. That's how we do it, kicking back.